with your own blood. And that they sing in Revelation, therefore worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive honor, glory, and power. Perhaps there's one today that you do not know Jesus Christ. Maybe the Father is drawing you right now to his Son, Jesus Christ. And this service would be a waste of time if we didn't give you the gospel and give you an opportunity to repent of sin and accept Jesus Christ as Savior of your life. If there is one today, these altar workers are here to minister the gospel to you in order that you can pass from death unto life. If there is a soul today, would you raise your hand? We pray for any today who are not saved. But we live in a dangerous world. We don't know what's going to happen from day to day. And so it's a dangerous thing to die and not know Jesus. Just remember that. Wherever eternity finds you, it's going to keep you right there. Don't ever forget that. Of all that you do, make sure that you know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life. Perhaps there's another, you're already saved and you believe God wants you to be a part of this fellowship. You've read the doctrine, and you visited and you prayed about it, and you really, really believe this is where God wants you to be. And we're always very low key on this, low pressure, because we understand that you have to be where God wants you to be. Amen? And so that's where we want you to be. But if there's one today, the altar workers can help you with that also. If there's one, if you just raise your hand. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we praise you and thank you for all things. Lord, I pray for those once again who are sick, John Fawcett, Jeff Miles, others on that prayer list. But also we praise you. As Deacon Scott was sharing in Sunday school, God finally opened up that door. Amen.
Amen.
For that job and that position that he enjoys. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
And so we want to make sure the redeemed of the Lord say so that God has answered that prayer. Amen.
Yes.
And Lord, we pray that that position turns into long-term and permanent. Mm-hmm. Father, we pray for our country. We pray for our land, our political leaders. Because more than anything, they need the grace of God. Father God, I praise you and thank you. In Jesus Christ's name. Let God's people say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Great opportunity to give back to you a small portion of the financial resources that you bless us with. And Lord, we ask and pray that as we give with free and willing hearts, according to your word, that you find this offering to be a favorable sacrifice unto thee. And Lord, again, as a church body, we ask for your wisdom and your guidance in the use of these funds so that they would be used to bring glory to your kingdom. And Lord, once again, as you hear and answer our prayer, we'll always be careful to give you all the praise, all of the honor and all of the glory. We pray these things in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 Please pray for Brother Brady and his family as they grieve the loss of his uncle in Alabama. Please pray for Brother John Peary, his sister Evelyn Gamble, and their family as they grieve the loss of her grandson. Please pray for Brother Tyrell Page McNeil and his family as they grieve the loss of Tyrell's grandfather, Opha Page. Pray for Evelyn Gamble, Brother John's sister. She is in the hospital with pneumonia. Please continue to pray for our church leaders and their families and those who need employment, and also those on our long-term prayer list. The Family Life Weekend to Remember Marriage Getaway will be held on March 4th, 5th, and 6th in Akron, Ohio. To receive a discount on enrollment, couples can use the group discount code LOVEFOREVER. Couples may sign up online at the link listed in your bulletins. For further information, check the website or see Brother Adrian McNeil. Save the date. Next Sunday, February the 28th, is our pro-life event made in his image. Please plan to join us at 6 p.m. and invite a friend. Tax statements have been emailed to members with an active email account. All others have been mailed. Please contact Pastor Smith if you have any questions. Women, if you will be participating in tonight's Mom in Touch 24/7, please see Sister Terry Kinlow for information. Upcoming dates to remember: Sunday, February the 21st, Moms in Touch 24/7, 6 to 8 p.m. And lastly, Sunday, February the 28th, is our pro-life event made in his image from 6 to 8 p.m. Pastor Smith?
For the men, for the pro-life event, sisters, we want you to come. But this is, it was started by Adrian, and this is actually a men, African-American Men for Life. So we want the sisters to come, but especially if you're a man, please come. There'll be some other speakers, Pastor Payton, I believe Pastor Mike Waters, I think Pastor Moss. But we'd like to see you there next Sunday evening at 6 to 8, and I'm sure it'll be good and a blessing. Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Just a couple of additional announcements. This year was our first year, trial year, of attempting to email out all of our tax statements. Some of you were successful. For some of you, it ended up in your spam. For some of you, I think you just deleted it because you saw it came from me. It's just a joke. So for those of you who did not get your tax statements, I have hard copies in case you need them today. So it was fairly successful. We'll get better as we move forward. Also, we are attempting to tighten up our security. I think a month ago, so Brother Bench, you correct me if I'm wrong, we asked for those who have keys to the church to sign up so that we know everyone that has a key. So if you haven't signed up, please see Brother Bench. Or you tell me if you're in here and you don't and you're not signed up with the key, he's going to let his vicious guard dog, the little Lopso Opso. And what's the other one? Just Stephanie? Pomeranian, the vicious guard dog. So if you have a key and you have not signed up on that list, please see Brother Vince after service. Let's stand. Our heads. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for the salvation that you brought for us with intent, Lord, for those who are called according to your purpose. Lord, we're so thankful for your mercy and for your grace. Lord, may we show that same mercy and grace to those who are lost by sharing the good news of the great gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord, may we glorify you throughout the week as we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 This is not